for you. Rudolph, people like waves wash over you. Squeezing your hands, feel the veins, babe. Hold and feel, take and steal. And it's all I can do.
Destination that we arrive at. Self-love is a relationship. That's one of the hardest ones. There are great days where you're feeling your own self, and there are days where you long to be free from your body. I can imagine for some people, they feel that self-love all the time. As a woman who is fat, queer, has skin mutations, holds trauma, who has been told repeatedly as a child that no one would ever love me, self-love is a process I go through every single day of my life. I have moved away from people I care deeply about so that I could get acquainted with my deeper self and my darkest emotions. I'm learning to sit with loneliness. I know sometimes it really feels like it. I know it won't kill me. I'm learning to listen to my anger and soothe it, rather than have it rule my life. I'm learning to forgive those who have hurt me, shaped unhealthy patterns, and made me suffer, because I see now how they were struggling as well. Today I shift into study with my solar plexus, my will and my power. I have forgiven a lot, and now I'm ready to reclaim the parts of myself which had to hide, had to run, were taken, were cut off, removed, torn away, broke. I'm ready to reclaim all the parts that I gave away, only to watch them be tossed to the ground. I'm ready to piece back together my power. No one else can do that for me, but I thank you all for coming here to bear witness to my vows. I'm so happy that I decided to come here and have my birthday here, and like be reminded of like my heart feels so full and it's been so like hard the last few months, and I've just been like worried that my heart was turning into stone because I felt so lonely. But I feel like part of like my karmic work is to like work past that loneliness and to like finally like be able to see and receive like all the love that you guys always are pouring on me and like helping me move forward. So like my wish for all of you is like carry your own self.
Yeah!
One here is just a little pomegranate flower. There's a little blue pill coming out of it. And the lady was like, this ring is about the story of Persephone. I don't know if you guys know this story, but it's this goddess who is like carefree little like maiden who just like hung out in the park and like this, like hung out with the nymphs and just like naked and have fun. The daughter of Zeus and Peter. And then her uncle Hades was like, hey Zeus, I need a bride. I want to marry your daughter. Back then, all the Greek gods were super incestuous. I mean, technically, I guess still are, because they still exist or whatever. And Zeus was like, yeah, go for it. My daughter. I own her. And so, Persephone's out in the meadow, chilling with her nymphs. And all of a sudden, the ground opens, and Hades comes with his chariot of hell horses and takes her down. And then Demeter, who is like the earth goddess, like all of a sudden like everything gets really quiet, like all the birds stop singing, the flowers stop singing, everything just shifts, and Demeter, this goddess of like the harvest, the food, of life changes. And she's like, where the fuck is this? And so she starts like searching, and she spends years and years and years searching for her, but can't find her. So she's like, I'm stopping crops from growing, everyone's gonna starve, everyone's gonna like have a bad time, so I'm pissed. And I'm gonna like, my hair's gonna turn into dreads, and I don't give a fuck. My face is gonna So meanwhile, while Peter's on Earth searching, Chris calls down to Katie. Katie's like, hey, are you hungry? And she's like, no. Because she knows that if she eats anything from down there, she's stuck in Peter's forever. So she's like, I won't eat. And so then one day, Katie tricks her and brings her a pomegranate and is like, hey, do you want a pomegranate? And she's like, okay, this time I'll do it. And so she had 5 seeds. And then basically, like, sealed the deal and stuff in Hades. And so, meanwhile, Demeter's up on the Earth, and she goes to Helios, the guy who, like, drives the sun by the chariot. And she's like, hey, I've seen my kid. And he's like, yes, I did. Hades took her down. So she's pissed. She goes fucking into Hades, and he's like, give back my daughter. And he's like, no, she ate pomegranate seeds. And somehow she convinced him, okay, you get her half a year and I get her half a year. And so he's like, cool. So that's why we get springtime, because that's when first plum comes back to the earth, and that's where the flowers start blooming again and everything. But in the winter, she goes back down. So I like this ring as like this idea. Sometimes we have to go to like hell and like sort out things with our demons and our devils, and like be acquainted with our demons and our devils, so that when we come back to like the joy, we can really like appreciate it and like understand freedom on a whole new level. So that's why I chose this ring. So today in front of all of you beloved people, I vow to hold space for my emotions no matter how big or small. I will sit and witness them even if it feels painful. I remember that as long as I am breathing, these feelings will not kill me. I vow to find ways to be kind to myself even on the hardest days. I vow to honor my truth and learn to walk away when my heart says to walk away. I vow to be more loving towards my body and treat it like a sacred palace. And trust in the choice my higher self made to come here like this. I will recognize the perfection of creation in my flaws and recognize my ancestors in my eyes and skin and soul. I vow to continue my creative process because it brings me so much joy and peace. I vow to uphold my word and recognize the services I provide for Mother Earth. I vow to forgive myself for all the ways I hurt the planet and make the changes in my life so they're more consciously on the land. I vow to learn a little bit every day from plants, rocks, animals, children, and elders. I vow to recognize my abundance and give thanks for all I receive. And lastly, I vow to restore my soul and all its powers and shine my light as brightly as possible. Show other people who are struggling with self-worth that this kind of love is possible. I take my power back with love and gratitude for the lessons I've learned. I invite you all to close your eyes and place your hand on your solar plexus. Take a moment to connect with your own internal sun. And know that your light shines brightly too. So, by the power invested in me from myself,
you're my grandma.
Anybody?
Johnny, too. No, I'm not asking much of you. Just sing, little darling, sing with me. Just sing, little darling, sing with me.
Oh, I know. I was thinking about that.
Sing, little darling, sing with me.
Ha ha ha!